In our recent videos, we posted some theories about the origins and the development of Standard Spanish in Latin America, but particularly the U.S. Today, we're going to dig into another subject which also unites Latinos all across the continent. Of course, I'm talking about El Chavo del Ocho, a TV show from the 70s which inspired just as many phrases, if not more, than Seinfeld, and one that continues to be enjoyed by Generation Z. And if you don't believe me, acúsame con tu mamá, Kiko. The question is, why? What is the pan-continental appeal of a Mexican sitcom born as a sketch inside the Chespirito show in 1972? What was it that made an orphan quote-unquote child, one who is living out of a barrel, and a rather unlikable cast of characters strike a chord with the Latin American continent? Roberto Gomez Bolaños had an intuition for creating mass entertainment. He mixed slapstick humor, innuendos, social caricatures, and more importantly, a sensibility shared across the continent, from melodramatic sappiness to extreme cruelty. Now, just for the lulz, let's go through some of the key elements that made this show so popular, many of which might not be so obvious to some of you. El Chavo del Ocho, in spite of being considered a show for kids, was actually conceived as a show for adults by its creator, Roberto Gomez Bolaños, who's also one of the main cast members. The fact that the show had adults playing kids made it a little weird, but it was also appealing because adults can say and do things that kids cannot, which leads us to our next observation.
El profesor visita la vecindad como buscando que haya boda.
El Chavo del Ocho is a comedy at heart, but the fact that some of its characters are carrying sexual romances with each other, or what do you think that tacita de café was about?
No gusta pasar a tomar una tacita de café.
Was both checking the mark of sex and romance in the show, making it more adult, but also spoofing telenovelas in passing. We mentioned Seinfeld before because that sitcom seems to be the high standard for seeding catchphrases. And if that's a test which measures success, Chespirito nailed it, starting with his alliterated use of CH in made-up words such as chiripiorca, or sayings such as se me chispoteó, which are still immensely popular. Plus, other phrases such as eso, 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 bueno, pero no te enojes, fue sin querer queriendo, just to name a few.
Vamos a luchar contra la ambición y rescataremos una princesa.
Yes, all of the characters in El Chavo live in a dirt poor vecindad. But even that tiny grouping of apartments and El Chavo's own barrel are microcosms of Latin American societies, the same ones in which people see differences based on their last names or even the color of their skin. For example, Doña Florinda always thought that she was above the rest of the vecindad, especially the humble Don Ramon.
¿Haría usted muy bien?
Vámonos, tesoro. No te juntes con esta chusma.
But the fact that she had a homeless kid living in a barrel a few feet away from her door made all of her pretensions funnier and sadder.
Aunque de repente les arrojen un pastel, golpes y porrazos,
porrazos, porrazos.
In the 1970s, society was less aware of the impact of violence in media. We were used to slapstick comedy because the likes of the Three Stooges still played on TV in the afternoons, and the notion of being politically correct was not important to media companies. But when you look at El Chavo today, the slapstick seems brutal. Then again, Mexico celebrates violence as a spectacle. And in the 1970s, pretty much all of Latin America was going through some very brutal times. Therefore, it's probably not much of a surprise that the violence in the show struck a chord. The violence in El Chavo del Ocho went beyond aggressive slapstick humor. It was also psychological. The show made fun of the way people looked,
cachetes de marrana flaca,
and also people being overweight or weak. Being poor, by either not having a ball to play with or a torta de jamón to eat, in El Chavo's case, was especially frowned upon. All of those things would now be considered bullying, but back then, it was just business as usual.
Qué bonita vecindad. Qué bonita vecindad.
think about it. The main characters in El Chavo del Ocho were not likable. Kiko was spoiled and cocky. La Chilindrina was loud and annoying. Doña Florinda was pretentious and angry. And again, they all treated the main character, a homeless person, like a nuisance. Which brings us to our last observation. El Chavo himself was the greatest mystery. He was an orphan living in a barrel, and he was always being punished for merely existing. He had no backstory, no one ever knew how he ended up there, and no one seemed to care, which gave him a mythical stature while touching on our nerves and guilt. Yet, for all of its insensitivity, the show has kept everyone coming back for more. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Check out the Americano on social media for more content.